Hi, I'm Vance, and welcome back to Repair and Replace. In this episode, I'll show you how to replace the hot surface igniter in a gas furnace. This is one of the most common points of failure, and it can easily be tested before replacing. A hot surface igniter works similarly to an incandescent light bulb. As electricity flows through the element, the resistance in the material generates heat, which causes the gas to ignite. Over time, the igniter can burn out and may appear singed or cracked. Now, this can be difficult to see, as even a small break can cause the igniter to fail. If the inducer motor runs but the igniter doesn't glow, then it's best to test the igniter for continuity before replacing. To begin, you'll need a hot surface igniter, a screwdriver or nut driver, and a multimeter. Now, there are a few different styles of igniters available, each with a different shape and size. So visit our website to find the right replacement. Also, be aware that there are no returns or refunds on electronic items once installed, so you may want to consult a trained professional before purchasing. When working on your furnace, always shut off the power and close the gas valve. Remove the top cover panel. Many furnaces use a push lock or twist lock, but some furnaces will require a screwdriver or a socket wrench. Trace the gas line up to the burner. The igniter should be on this side. In some furnaces, it'll be hidden behind a cover. Now, disconnect the wires. Next, unscrew and remove the igniter, but be careful not to touch the element. Take the multimeter and set it to the lowest ohms of resistance. Now touch the probes to each terminal. If the igniter has continuity, your multimeter should read anywhere from 30 to 200 ohms. If there is no reading on the multimeter, or just a slight change, then there is no continuity and you will have to replace the igniter. Align the new igniter and tighten the screw. Now reconnect the wires. Now replace the upper cover. Next, open the gas valve. Now, turn on the power to your furnace. The furnace should be running normally. If you're still unsure what's causing the problem in your furnace, then watch our troubleshooting guide for a step-by-step breakdown. And there's a link to this in the description below. If you found this video useful, then subscribe to our channel. We're constantly filming new content every week, so let us know what repairs you'd like to see next. And if you need a part for that repair, then visit our website. We stock thousands of hard-to-find parts, and we'll ship it out to you the same day. Thanks for watching.